In 2007, Steve Jobs unveiled the first ever iPhone, a true engineering achievement that would revolutionize communication forever. And over the past 14 years, the only new additions made have been some extra cameras that make your phone look like a Scholastic Book Fair DJ kit. And so that got me thinking, if none of these rich businessmen inventors are gonna do anything to forward technology, I'll just have to do it myself. And so today I'm gonna tell you about how me and a group of friends worked together to create a true feat of human engineering. Step one was making the design. Now, the five of us that were working together to create this thing were all in the same engineering class, where the rule was pretty much as long as you were building something, you got an A. So we had plenty of time to sit down and rationally think out ideas for what to build and how to build it. And by that, I mean we spent 5 minutes shouting ideas at each other from across the room while sifting through piles of parts. What about a tractor? That's stupid. Maybe a boat? This is the third time you suggested a boat. We're not building a fucking boat. What about a tank? We've done that before. Yeah, but what if you dink this one even shittier? Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner, folks. Grab some gears and let's get going. And thus, our ragtag group of amateur engineering students set out to create the most technologically advanced shitty tank of all time. Its name? Dimiti, Destroyer of Worlds, star of Bill Gates' wet dreams. Now, three of the guys in the group had already built something similar earlier in the year, so we got through the fundamentals such as the base and the tread pretty quickly. We then quickly veered away from the fundamentals when one of us suggested, what if we put a fucking chainsaw on it? Then we put a chainsaw on it. We then proceeded to slap four random sheets of metal along the base to enclose the motor, and soon enough our bouncing baby boy was starting to look just like a tank. A big metal box with a chainsaw on it. But sadly, this is where things started to draw to a close. Besides taking a few test drives around the school and adding a slingshot to the top of him, which we would use to randomly shoot hunks of metal at each other while we were building, not much more got done on Dimiti before the great pestilence hit and we were taken away from school, forced to leave behind our pride and joy. Although, you know, it might have been a good thing, because the next component we were planning on adding to him was literally an automated turret which we were going to use to shoot screws. So, when we finally got in contact with our engineering teacher again, we were told the bad news. Dimiti, our little over-engineered buckaroo, was disassembled and turned to scrap for the next class to use. But Dimiti lives on forever in our hearts. I'll never forget the way that random screws that we didn't remember using would fall out of him whenever we would turn him over to make adjustments. I only hope that before God took him, he shuddered in fear, the way we always intended. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and peace out.